Today we will discuss about some problems which depend upon modern periodic table. Okay. First problem is how we can find out group and period of any element by the using of its atomic number. For example, if we have the atomic number 23, 24, then how we can find out the group and period number of these two elements which having atomic number 23 and 24. So first we have write down the electronic configuration of this 23. It becomes 2 8, plus 2 12, and 23 minus 12, that is 11. 11 2. This is the electronic configuration of each unknown element. Now this electronic configuration write down in the same structure and orbital. So we have 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, and 3d6 plus 2 8, 3d4, and 4s2. In this situation, we have extending one electron, 4s goes into 3d. Since after extending of one electron, 3d becomes 3d5. There is more stable due to the stable half free electronic configuration. So its real configuration becomes, this one becomes 10 electron. So we have write neon. Now after neon, 3s2, 3p6, 3d5. 4s1. Now, finding out the first period of this element. So, basically, period means number of last orbit. Here is the number of last orbit is 4. So, this 23 atomic number element belongs to the 4th period. It means its period number becomes 4. Now, next, we are finding the group. Actually, in this element, the last electron enter in the 3d orbital. So this element belongs to d block, equals to block equals to d, and its group number means with the addition of n minus 1d electron plus ns electron. Here is the n minus 1d electron becomes 6. And ns electron becomes 1, equals to 7. So its group number is 7. So we can say that atomic number 23 element belongs to 4th period d block, where its group number becomes 7. No, it's 24. This is answer for the 24, not for the 23. Since we have write down 24, not 23. Now we have for solving this question, we are discussing some rules. The first rule is if last electron enter in ns orbital, then element belongs to the s block. And second one is the period number becomes number of last orbit. Number of last orbit. Number third one is for the finding its group number. Rest block element, its group number becomes number of ns electron. So by the help of these three rules, we can find out the grid number, group number, and also block, so that's block elements. For example, we are taking an example of 19, 38. So first, what of 19? 19, it's 2, 8, 8, 1. Or 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 p 6, 3 is 2, 3 p 6, 4 is 1. So its last electron enter in the 4s orbital, that is called its valence shell. So its period number becomes 4. Now what about its group number? According to third rule, group number is number of ns electron, n means the number of last orbit. So here the ns electron is 1, so its group number becomes 1 or first. Now in this element, the last electron enter in the ns orbital, so it has the block equals to s. Atomic number 38, we have atomic number 38. Now its electronic complement becomes 2, 8, 18, 18. That is 18 plus 18, 36, 36 plus 10, 48. No? Yes. 18 plus 10, that is 28, and remaining 10 electron, which becomes 8, 2. Now it's 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 p 6, 3 is 2, 3 p 6, 3 d 10, 4 is 2, 4 p 6, and 5 is 2. Now the block of this element becomes, block becomes s, since last electron entered in the s orbital or s subset. Now its period number becomes 5. Since this number is 5, now its group number, according to third rule, its group number becomes number of ns electron, that is 2. So its group number 2, here is the group number is 2, means this element belongs to the second group, fifth period, and its block becomes s. Now the rule for finding of the p block elements. First is, if last electron enter p orbital, then it's a p block element. Then it's the p block element. And second one is, its period number equals to number of last orbit or last shell. Third becomes its group number becomes number of ns electron, number of ns electron plus np electron. Now we will apply some molecules, so some atoms. For example, if you have atomic number 13, now 35. So the first solving the problem for 13. 13, its electronic configuration becomes 2, 8, 3. Now it's 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 p 6, 3 is 2, 3 p 1. In this element, last electron enters in the p orbital, so its block becomes p. Now its period number becomes 3. Now finding its group number becomes ns electron plus np electron. For this element, n is 3. And then the value of the number of last orbit, here the include of 3s and 3p both. So total number of ns and np electron becomes ns electron 2 and np electron is 1. So its group number becomes 3. Now the other element, that is 35, its electronic configuration becomes 2, 8, 18, 2, 8, 18, that is 18 plus 2, 20, 20 plus 8, 28, 28 and 7, that is 35. Now it's 1 is 2, 2 is 2, 2 p 6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p5. Now block of this element becomes p. Block becomes p since last electron entered the p orbital. Now its period number, it becomes 4 since 4 is the number of last orbit. Now its group number becomes number of ns electron plus number of np electron. It is the ns means 4s2, that becomes number of electron 2 plus np electron means number of electron 5. So here is the total number of electron 7. In the p block element, after finding this number, then actual finding the group number according to model periodic table, we are adding 10. So its actual group number becomes 10 plus 7, that becomes 17. This group number according to Mendeley periodic table, but model periodic, according to period model periodic table, its group number becomes 17. For the finding of group, for the finding of group number of p block element in MPT model periodic table, group number equals to ns electron plus np electron plus 10. Now discuss the rules about finding the b block element. Rules for d block element. First is, if last electron enter in n minus 1d orbital, there is an interesting thing, that is end is not possible. End is not possible since maximum electron in n cell of any element equals to 8 according to Bohr-Wari scheme. So these 8 electrons occupy in ns and np orbital. Since the capacity of ns is 2 and the np becomes 6, so these 8 electrons are consumed in the ns and np orbital, and nd orbital always start from ns and np orbital. Now second one is period number, number of last orbit. Third one is group number, number of n minus 1d electron plus ns electron. So for example, the atomic number becomes 21, 22. So first, the solution of atomic number 21 means 2 8 9 2. 8 plus 2 10, 10 plus 10 19, 21. Now it becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, and 4s2, 3d1. Since the energy of the 4s orbital lesser becomes 3d orbital, that's why first electron enters 4s in place of 3d. And this element period number becomes 4. There is interesting that its last orbit becomes 4. All the last electron enter in 3D. Its group number becomes n minus 1d electron, n minus 1d electron plus ns electron. There is the n means 4 minus 1d electron plus ns electron means 4s electron. So here is the 3d electron plus 4s electron. 3d electron becomes how many? 1. And 4s electron becomes 2. So total number becomes 3. Means group number equals to 3. and its block equals to d, since last electron enter in this 3d orbital. Now if the atomic number is 22, its electronic configuration becomes 2, 8, 9, 2, or 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d2. And this element, if we discuss about block, that becomes d. Last electron enter is a d. Now its period number, that becomes 4. And its group number, it becomes n minus 1d electron plus ns electron. There is the n minus 1d means 3d, and total electron in 3d becomes 2. This power indicates the number of electron, that becomes 2, and ns electron becomes 2. So its group number becomes 4. Now we have discussed about f block elements. First one is, if last electron enter in n minus 2 f orbital, there is the nf and n minus 1 f, both are not possible. Both are not possible. Since n shell having 8 electron maximum and n minus 1 shell having 18 electron maximum according to Bohr-Bari scheme. So in the n shell, this 8 electron consuming ns plus np. This capacity is 2 and this capacity is 6. And after nsnp, we are discussing nd and nf. So and in the n minus 1d, total 18 electrons. So first electron enter ns2, then np, then nd. So here is the n minus 1 f is not possible. So if we have about discussing f orbital, then it will be always n minus 2f. So for example, next second rule is, its period number of last orbit. Now if you have discussed about its group number, so here is the interesting thing that all f block elements, that is also called lanthanum actinides, are placed in third group of the periodic table. Due to the presence of these lanthanum actinides or f block elements in the third group, it is the largest group of the modern periodic table. We have discussed an example. For example, we have taken the example of lanthanum and cerium. Lanthanum is 57 and cerium is 58. Lanthanum is considered to a d block element, while cerium is considered to a f block element. We writing the electronic configuration of this lanthanum, that is 57, that becomes 2, 8, 18, and if you are writing again 18 plus 18, 36 plus 10 46, then how many electrons? That is 11. So we have write to 11, 9, 2. Now this becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 5s2, 5p6, 5d1, 6s2. So the last electron entered in the n minus 1d, that is 5d electron. So it's a d block element, and its group number becomes 3 and period number becomes 6. Now if we are discussing about electron configuration of this 58, then that becomes 2, 8, 18, 19, 9, 2. So here these 10 element becomes neon, 10 turn over 10, and then after 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, now 4s2, 4p6, 4d10, 4f1, 5s2, 5p6, 5d1, 6s2. Basically, when we have written the electron of this electronic configuration according to above rule, then we are finding the Last electron enter in the 4f orbital. So its block becomes 4. Its block becomes f. And its period number, that is the number of last orbit, that becomes 6. Its group number becomes 3, since this 3 number fixed for all the f block elements.